extraordinary, even more than anyone that you adore can love. Will you say yes to me?
Hello. 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 Welcome, everyone. Welcome. Thank you so much for coming. Look around this room. It's like a reunion. There are so many people here from so many different facets of Dwayne's life. Travel friends, drag friends, work friends, court friends, just friends, friends. This night was not supposed to happen right now. It's all of us are trying to figure out why are we here. This wasn't supposed to happen, but the reality is it did. And looking out at this beautiful room of all these wonderful people, it just makes me feel, thank you. I like your hair. Dwayne would be so happy right now. I just, looking at everybody, looking at all of you, I just keep thinking, I literally keep thinking because the vibe, the music, the lights, the food, the drinks, I'm like, Dwayne's gonna walk in any minute. We're all wearing his beaded dresses tonight. Dwayne did such a good job making sure that all of us looked fabulous. So, thank you. First of all, Greg. Can we give it up for Greg? Greg, it's unimaginable. It's unimaginable what Greg is feeling, what Greg is going through. But as we've all said again and again to Greg, that he is not alone. Everyone in this room, we're here for Lotta, but we're also here for Greg. This has been an unimaginable year of loss for many of us in the room on so many different levels. And tonight, coming together to just embrace each other, to embrace Greg, to embrace the love and friendship that Lotta brought to all of us, it's just so important. So it's kind of wacky that it's Thanksgiving weekend. So I know that everyone in this room is thankful for having met Dwayne Lotta. So what today is about, what tonight is not about sadness and boohooing, and I'm clearly fired. As Champagne and Bill said, we have to stop meeting like this. Our community comes together again and again at times like this, and it's so sad and it's so wrong, and it just is a reminder, you know, Lotta loved to party. Lotta loved to party, she loved to get everybody together, let's just eat and drink. We need to remember to do that more often, because one day we won't be able to, right? So thank you all for coming out. Tonight, you know, Greg doesn't need any flowers or any, you know, chocolates. Well, you can bring the chocolates to the dressing room, but no flowers. But anybody that would like to give a remembrance to Lotta, you know, Lotta helped with the Pride of the Rose Scholarship Fund with her Emperor Scotty, along with Allison Gray and Frank, of course, who started it. So today our little tube there, if you would like to give remembrance in honor of Lotta, Dwayne, let's make donations to the Pride of the Rose. Today, I know I'm up here like a fool boohooing, but as a hooker, but a lot of us tonight, I know she always made my dresses so short, and she said it was my belly that made them short. That we were very close. So a lot of us tonight are wearing the beaded dresses that Lotta made. So a lot of you know this, but some of you don't know. Lotta made these dresses literally one bead at a time, painstakingly, just sitting there, just got off work at the Commodore, came home, and poor Greg, I mean, all he ever saw was the top of the head, because she's just going like this. And that sounded weird, but Lotta just made these, and we have, Misha and I, you know, we love Lotta for so many years and did so many things together. We have so many colors, and like, we don't even have, there's not enough of tonight's event to wear all of the ones that Lotta made for. She just made them, she loved them, and she put one at a time, and then put, and then, oh, I don't know. So I want to think that Lotta, with each bead, was giving a memory for the person that she made it for. The things we did together, the laughter we shared, the gossip. Some of you in this room were talked about. And so tonight when you see people in the fringe beads, Lotta made them, and we'll always wear them, remembering her. Okay, so I was asked to do this because I'm usually the stoic, bitchy one, and here I am just falling apart. Order of the evening, cocktail hour, we did that. Welcome, I did that. Pride of the Rose announcement, remember, fill up the bucket. And calm down. Thank you to her, Lotta's Emperor Scotty and Eric. When the situation happened at coronation, obviously we had to take care, everybody had to take care of Lotta, but all of these flowers and everything you see, they were part of coronation. That's what Lotta brought in, and it had to be taken care of. And so Scotty, thank you for taking it all and bringing it back today. It's kind of a full circle moment in a weird way since coronation to today. So thank you, Scotty. I know a lot of you are new to the situation. The court, the Imperial Sovereign Rose Court, was such a big part of Dwayne's life. It was so important to him. He was so proud of the work he had done with the ISRC. And while it is fantasy and fiction and, you know, play and sometimes bullshit on a Monday night, the first of the month, what's real is the relationship between an emperor and an empress. And so, Scott Fox, our heart's with you too. So thank you for keeping it together and getting this all together. Okay, we have to go. It's time to start. People say, Poison, how did you meet Lotta? Well, this is decades ago before there was, what's that thing called? Social media, and you know, reaching out to people. And I met Lotta at the Montgomery Park where the La Femme was, and his name was Dwayne, and I didn't know him. I'm like, your husband's hot, but I don't know you. And kept like reaching out, and like, I want to do drag. I'm like, oh God, if I hear one more person wants to do drag, that's all we need in this town. And then I was at work at the State of Oregon Department of Environmental Quality with Kimberly Van Patten, and the biggest, most obnoxious balloon bouquet came to my office. It was stupid huge. It was dumb. It was gigantic. And the note said, what is it going to take to get your attention to respond to me, Dwayne Witzel? And I was like, oh, this guy's serious. And he said, come to lunch. And I was like, okay. So we went to lunch. And when he said my restaurant, I thought the restaurant he cared for. No, he owned it. Okay, I was like, oh, okay. So we had a wonderful time. Dwayne wanted to be in drag so bad, so bad. And sometimes you're just like, oh, it's not really your time, but okay. Dwayne got in drag and killed it. When Dwayne committed to drag and he wanted to be Lotta Liquor so bad with every fiber of his being, and he did it, and he drew us all in. He sold the fantasy to all of us. And I always remember that's how Dwayne reached out. I'm like, oh, yeah. And then that was foreshadowing for a lot of things in the future. Dwayne went big. Okay. Back to the notes. Greg's like, girl. Okay. Now we're going to bring to... Shut up, Gina. Now we're going to bring to the stage Reverend Constance Hammond. Keep clapping, they're coming.
I have a mic. Well, Poison, I'm here to celebrate, as we all are, Dwayne Lotta's life. And so I don't mean to bring the party down by being a priest and reading a little scripture, but I think it's important to have a little bit of everything and to remember that the celebration of life is something that we should all remember and live, because one never knows. And so I ask you to sit in a moment of prayer. Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, deal graciously with Greg, Dwayne's husband of 32 years, his sisters Linda Ho, Lisa Bauman, his brothers Corey Witzel, Brian Witzel, and Troy Bonner, his mother Cheryl Bonner, his Aunt Bev, and all his many, many, many friends and relatives. Comfort them in their grief, surround them with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come. Through Christ's name we pray. And then a reading from Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to laugh. A time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. May you all know the peace that is here for all of us in all of creation, and live a life that would honor Dwayne Lotta.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight, Reverend Constance Hammond. And now, please welcome to the stage, Lotta's Princess 34, Rhonda Marie.
Hi, everybody. I'm gonna say it again, we're here for a celebration of life. Hello. Thank you. You just helped my tears stay back just a little bit more. Thank you, Joey. Perfect. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Awesome. Turn it a little bit this way. So I am honored and privileged for so many things. One of them was being Dwayne's friend and for being him choosing me as his princess and cementing a friendship of over 20 years. He will be missed, but he will be celebrated by each and every one of us here and anybody outside of here. I I'm going to be reading what Greg wrote, which is filled with much love and things a lot of us didn't know. A couple things Greg didn't know, but that's okay, they're happy things. So Dwayne's life began on January 1st, 1962, in Portland, Oregon. He was adopted by Jerry and Shirley Witzel. Life was a busy one for them, as it was their first child. And as Dwayne always said, they should have just stopped at one, as I was the perfect child. I think a few of us heard that a time or two. 2 years later, his sister Linda was adopted in Portland. Jerry and Shirley lived in a few places, Albany and Pendleton, before the next two boys, Brian and Corey, were born 4 and 6 years later in Pendleton. After, I brought a hanky with me because my nose is running, but if I get a little dark, let me know because I love poison music. I'm a pale girl, that's all I'm saying. I did, I love poison. He's just darker complexioned than I am. I'm a pale girl. After working for the Forest Service, living in Pendleton for 9 years, Jerry took a new job in Edmonds, Washington, where they lived until Dwayne graduated from Edmonds High School in 1981. He had various jobs, cooking for church camps, and he even had his own wedding cake business in high school. This doesn't surprise me. And we all know how much Dwayne loved to cook. It was his love language. He moved back to Portland and stayed with his grandma True, learned square dancing, round dancing, had a few jobs, but landed a great office manager job for a tech business where he stayed before the dot-com business took them out. He met his first partner in his early 20s. They separated, and then he found Willie, who he stayed with for 7 years before Willie passed away from lung cancer. Dwayne said he waited for 2 years before looking again for a relationship. Well, Greg found him while they were ice skating at Lloyd Center in August of 1992. It was about 6 months later, Dwayne was back again ice skating and approached Greg to skate with his group of friends. For Greg, it was love at first sight. Greg called Dwayne that night, and their 32-year adventure began. Linda said Dwayne called her one evening and said, "I found the guy I love, and he's cute too." Dwayne had never called Linda before about love. Dwayne and Greg sold their houses and purchased this Pine Street house in 1995. Various remodels and painting over the years place it as you see it today. Warm, beautiful, and I'm gonna add the word inviting. It is truly a home for all. Their house was one of his pride and joys, making it a home and inviting people for dinner and fun. Dwayne always loved Christmas and decorated to the nines every room he could with Christmas. During the Christmas party of the year, everyone looked forward to going to. Sorry, everybody. It's my sinuses. Oh, he not only cooked all the food, cakes and candies, he did it to raise money for charity for our house Camp KC, and the Pride of the Rhodes Scholarship. He was always doing for others and wanted nothing in return. Dwayne never sat still. Yeah. This we all know. At the time, as me and Greg and buying the Pine Street house, Dwayne also purchased the Commodore Grill and Lounge, another pride and joy.
Yeah.
That's right. He loved talking with the patrons and giving bartender advice and telling them to get their life straightened out. And to quit coming in and seeing him every morning. He always wanted people to succeed as he did. He always said, I don't have a college degree, just a high school degree. Don't complain and work hard. You can do it. Dwayne and Greg traveled all around the world, meeting friends everywhere. India was Dwayne's first international trip with Darcel, Roxy, and Barbara. They met more lifelong friends, people like George and Caroline Finn. What an adventure, meeting lifelong friends, boy, I don't want to say lifelong tonight, sorry everybody. And then traveling to China, then England, Italy, and Spain. Once they got the cruise ship bug, they hit the high seas with Scott, Corey, Frank, JL, and many times Greg's mom, Dee, from the Baltic Sea, sorry, to the Greek islands, Egypt, Italy, Panama, Vietnam, Thailand, and the Caribbean. Even with all the travels, Dwayne's favorite relaxing vacation was always Hawaii. He loved to sit by the pool, drink his water, listen to tunes. Yeah. It's good to know I wasn't the only one who chuckled at that when I read. Just saying. So he loved to sit by the pool, drink his water, listen to tunes, while the ocean waves crashed next to him. Dwayne never did anything small if he could help it, as many of us know. Dwayne was asked to perform at Peacock in the Park, June 28, 2015. He thought and thought and thought. Then secretly between a few friends, it was a lot more than a few friends that were behind all that, by the way. He said he was going to ask Greg to marry him. Well, that went over like a space shuttle taking off. It was 2 days after the Supreme Court approved gay marriage, and there were 4,000 people celebrating the marriage of two people that deeply loved each other. And I'm gonna add on a little bit to that, because there was a lot of people involved with that. Kimberly, Maria, Poison, Misha, me, Kathleen, Sheila. I had to get on the phone with Greg and tell him he wasn't gonna wear jeans to Peacock in the Park. I said, your princess is gonna be in face, and I don't want you in shorts, I don't want you in jeans, I want you in nice pants and a shirt. He was not happy with me. I said, just do it, please. And I'm sure many of you saw pictures of that ceremony. You can also, if you want, go onto YouTube and see it. It was beautiful. And Lotta made sure there was cake for everybody in the park. And as you saw, there were never many pictures of Dwayne and Greg apart. Dwayne was always hollering in the house, "Hello, I'm in here," always wanting to be together, touching, snuggling, or just next to each other watching TV. Dwayne wasn't much for public affection, but would slap hands or just quickly touch each other lovingly as they would go for a walk. And sometimes it doesn't take the touch, but to see the love they had was beautiful. He always said he had a hallmark moment in 2019 when he met his birth mother, Cheryl, and his half-siblings, Lisa and Troy. This relationship built over the years with visits in Portland and Spokane and countless phone calls. What a treat it was to see Dwayne happy at finding out about his family. Dwayne and I also talked, I'm originally from Spokane, and he said, "Wouldn't it be something if we were related?" And I went, "I don't know about that." And it wasn't for Dwayne and his family, I said, "You've met my family. You've met my mother. My mother was adopted also." We cannot forget about Lotta Liquor. Yeah, please. And I'm going to say this before I continue on. Do not ever celebrate Lotta or Dwayne in silence. Ever. He was not a silent man. Yeah, silence was not his word. He expressed what he felt. He fought for everybody. It didn't matter what community, who you were. So always celebrate him with your voice and kindness. We cannot forget about Lotta Liquor, who came into the picture about 2001, 2002. Mostly a dare from Poison Waters. Since you're following me around as Empress, you should run for the title debutante. Of course he ran, and he won the title. Dwayne was born to create dresses and buy jewelry. And he was really good at both. Out of high school, he really thought about going to design school. He designed, beaded, and made so many costumes for himself and friends, and we can't even begin to count. And as Poison said, you're gonna see fringe all over this room as the afternoon goes on. That was a lot of get home from work and just start beading. There was a lot of us who learned how to bead, how to purl. We don't have fingerprints anymore from hot glue guns, but we were always willing to help. In 2003, Dwayne put his application in for Rose Empress. He ran an impressive campaign and won the title of Rose Empress, the radiant Rose Empress. 46. Yes. Bishop Walker won the title of emperor, and their friendship was born. Over the years, Lauda and Scott visited cities in Canada and USA, raised countless of dollars. I would begin to say hundreds of thousands of dollars. And our motto, as Scotty always says, $1 at a time is all it takes to help. And their passion was the Pride of the Rose Scholarship, which Daddy Frank is still involved, and Daddy Frank and Scotty, it's up the two of you, for Allison and Lotta are gonna be looking down, and I wouldn't wanna have those 9 years if you guys were going to. Oh, what a dynamic duo. They became friends to raise money while having a blast, and friends to share travels around the world. Coronation, October 2023, was their 20th year anniversary as Emperor and Empress. Lotta and Scott performed a flawless, spectacular number. There were friends on stage from all over during the number. It was amazing. Sadly, on October 22nd, 2023, Dwayne flew with the Angels. Dwayne is survived by his husband and best friend of 32 years, Greg Baumgartner, his sister Linda Hoag, brothers Corey Witzel and Brian Witzel, half-sister Lisa Bowman, half-brother Troy Bonner, mother Cheryl Bonner, and lots of nieces and nephews and many, many friends and relatives. Dwayne loved everybody. As I said, Greg wrote this, and we all need to remember, Lotta's not physically here with us. My dear, sweet friend, Greg is. And it is our job to make sure that Greg remembers how special he is to all of us. We're celebrating Lotta tonight. But we are all in this room for you, Gregory. You, yes, please. There wouldn't have been the Dwayne that we know or the Lotta Marie Licker that we know, both of who we loved, without the support of you, Gregory. There's a lot of memories that we can all share. Some of them I don't think we should. We just keep them to our own personal self. Maybe at another time we can share those in a different environment. But as I said before, celebrate this incredible human being, never in silence. And I ask each and every one of you as hard as it may be, not to, excuse my language, bitch, moan, complain, yak about things that really don't have a relevance. Spread your kindness, spread your love. If you can't do it for yourself and your community and the people in this room, do it in the name of Dwayne Witzel. My friendship isn't going away with Dwayne. I'm certainly not thinking, Gregory, he's going to throw me out at some point. And I don't even live there. So they block me, though. I shall forever remain Bodice Princess in the honor that I will take with me for the rest of my life. And I want to thank each and every one of you for being here, for celebrating, for holding on to one another. Have a great night, and don't forget about the bucket that's right up front there. Dollar bills, coins, five cents, 20s, 50s, 100s. It's not prejudice, you might want to put in there. It'll all go to the Pride of the Rose. Thank you all again, and enjoy this wonderful celebration.
I was wondering if I had time to change. Girl, I had time to shave. She was there for a long time. By the way, I'm a man. Okay, so thank you so much for removing Rhonda's props. Okay, so earlier in the planning, weeks and weeks ago, there were folks that, you know, that said, I would like to speak at Dwayne's Celebration of Life. And then there were folks who were like, no, I definitely don't want to. So we purposely didn't list names in the program because, you know, people change their mind as the mood strikes. So now is the time that folks that were planning to speak can come line up behind this black curtain, and we're going to bring you on. And if you weren't planning to speak, but you've been moved to speak, we'd love to hear your thoughts as well. So come on back. I don't want to like say names because I don't want to put anybody on the spot, but you know who you are, so get back there. And do you think people want the microphone stand? No? I don't know. Okay. I'll be back. Wish me luck. Calm down, team. I hear you.
Celebration of Dwayne's life, know a bit about Dwayne, and we've all watched enough TV to know something of, say, the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills or New York City. But as his neighbor, I can definitely say Dwayne is the real, R-E-A-L, housewife of Pine Street. Housewife has taken on a double meaning. If the person in question is not a housewife, but rather a housewife, the image looks different from, say, June Cleaver. This housewife wears jewel-toned ball gowns and pivots to the camera while saying her signature catchphrase. She takes multiple vacations and cruises each year. She hosts themed parties and holds long grudges. she may occasionally wield a knife to apply peanut butter to a slice of bread or prepare a homemade meal, but it's just a symbol of how grounded she is and wants to appear. She is, after all, real. So let's break this down. Starting with the jewel-toned ball gowns, Lotta's walk-in closet is stuffed with hand-beaded gowns of every length in becoming pinks, silvers, and blacks. Matching boas, tiaras, rings, and earrings complement each outfit. There are multiple wig options, racks of shoes, hundreds of boxes of fake nails, which I think she would still like to sell you. But most importantly, Lotta has the legs to wear them all. Multiple vacations. Dwayne spent hours each day dreaming about travel. The big island of Hawaii was always on the list, as were cruises with friends. I spent many hours trying to convince Dwayne not to ruin his vacation paradise by moving there. My ulterior motive was, of course, always to keep him living across the street. Themed parties. What could be more Dwayne than the Christmas party Pride of the Rose fundraiser, with decorated trees in every room, tables groaning from the weight of ham, turkey dressing, and an additional room for all the desserts and candies. What set the party apart is the fact that it was all handmade by Dwayne. Let's not forget the canned peaches, pickles, salsa, the list goes on. Dwayne has every party supply for any event you could think of, including table decor and matching party favors. Holds long grudges. I asked for a show of hands, but we're really here to celebrate him tonight. Maybe a better title is something like, my grandmother might say, Dwayne was a kvetch. Or is busybody a more apt description? Dwayne loved to walk Pine Street and check in with the neighbors. When I first moved across the street, Dwayne made a beeline to introduce himself and then added, in an aside typical to Dwayne, "I'm so glad you got rid of those ugly planters on the front porch." Dwayne was always happy to gossip. He knew who wasn't getting along, who was buying a new car, who was preparing to move. He vacillated between counting down the days to retirement, bitching about work, people in general, life in Portland, and cars parked too long on the street. To me, what makes Dwayne so special is that he was so real with everyone. He was open and willing to share how he was feeling, tempered, of course, with a good dose of biting commentary. He genuinely cared for other people and often went above and beyond to bead jackets, bake cakes, visit people in the hospital, or run an errand. He was also inquisitive. He truly wanted to know how you were doing. You could always borrow a cup of sugar or an onion. Any given afternoon, you could count on Dwayne waltzing into the kitchen after a brief knock and shooting the breeze while he waited for Greg to get home. Dwayne was not a superficial TV housewife, but the glue to our neighborhood, the kind of friend everyone wants to have in their life. He made every party brighter by his kindness and wit. He was fiercely loyal and demonstrated genuine interest in people. Maybe Jim Cleaver could have used a little dash of Dwayne. I miss him every day. Why don't you raise your glass in Dwayne's honor? Thank you.
Hi. I've known Dwayne probably 40 years. My name is Sandy Langman Corboy. Some of you know me as Sandy Future. I own clothing stores in Portland for years. I met Dwayne back in the days when Stark Street was the street. I was out partying at CC Slaughter's on a Sunday. 50 cent pounders, 50 cent schnapps. We were getting our money's worth. So at some point, Willie Wager, who was soon to become Dwayne's boyfriend, and I got into some kind of a row with who, I don't know. We bolted out of CC Slaughter's, ran out in the street with people chasing us. Up the street is a silver truck, our knight in shining armor. I didn't know yet. I'm wearing a pencil skirt. Couldn't hardly run. And Dwayne is driving up. Willie starts screaming, "It's Dwayne! It's Dwayne! That's my new boyfriend! It's Dwayne!" And so I'm like, okay. He's like, "Jump in the truck." Okay. So I did the Fosbury flop into the back of the truck. Willie dove into the truck. Willie yells at Dwayne, "Dwayne, this is Sandy. Sandy, this is Dwayne. Drive, drive." And we drove up the street probably all the way to Silverado, where we continued drinking. A lot of people know a lot of liquor too. That's kind of Dwayne's drag. Well, how many of you know Wynonna Judd? That was his first drag. Dwayne and I did a benefit at Montgomery Park, and we both performed, and that was the first time, as far as I know, Dwayne wore a wig, a crinoline, and looked like Wynonna, and he did a fabulous job. He also earned his first title there. A weird title that Willie and I had created called Those Debbies. It came from that song, you know, everybody run, the homecoming queen's got a gun. So, stop it, Debbie, you're embarrassing me. Well, that night, we gave Dwayne his first hot pink banner. He was Those Debbie, number 3. So, they always had, Dwayne and Willie always had fabulous parties at their little house over in Lad's Edition, which usually ended up with Dwayne with a huge spread, Dwayne with a lot of drinks that we all drank, and me and Willie ending up with half the Christmas trees all over ourselves. A few years passed, and then we unfortunately lost Willie to cancer. And that was a really hard day when Dwayne took me and Willie into the Virginia Cafe, and we sat there and cried and cried and cried. And then a week later, we lost Willie. But Dwayne stayed my friend. He kept being my friend. I dressed him like cute little costumes that he had purchased in my store. And then he met Greg. And he kept being my friend. And Greg has become my friend. And I just, this was, losing Dwayne, it was a gut punch. The last time I saw him was at Pride. I just finished, I work at Nordstrom's now. I just finished marching with Nordstrom's in the parade. And I'm walking back to work, because that's what I do. I go straight to work after I do things. So I'm all glittered out, and I see somebody on a Segway in an orange beaded gown, hot blonde, orange beaded gown, and I start screaming, "Dwayne, spins that thing around." And we talk, we said, "See you later." And unfortunately, the later never happened. So I know that there's rainbow bridges for dogs and cats. I believe there's a rainbow bridge for Dwayne, too. And in Dwayne, in honor of Dwayne, I'd like to rename the pearly gates to the crystal gates, because they're gonna sparkle and shine. And before I become Alice Cooper with my mascara running down my face, I just want Greg to know that I love him dearly, and I love Dwayne too. And I always will.
Hi everyone, my name's Jenny. I am Dwayne's cousin. He was my first baby cousin I ever got to hold. And always a joy to have in my life. Take a breath. Put on my big girl pants. Dwayne and I had a lot of fun. We were like two and three in the family of cousins. And so as the other ones came along, we got to torture them a lot and cause a lot of trouble for our parents, I'm sure. But we were buddies, we hung out a lot, we did lots together. We had slumber parties at our house and we just always had a really good time. And he made my wedding cake the first time I got married. Didn't last, but you know. It was a beautiful cake. It was a beautiful cake. And you know, it was the 70s, so you had the gunny sack dresses. And I think he did our flowers. He did my sister Cindy's wedding cake. That one didn't last either, but we're pretty sure it wasn't the cake. So, Dwayne was always an adventurer. We have been camping together. We've been, you know, like all these family, we lived like a block away from each other when we were little kids, so we were always together. I remember this one time, you know, it was the 60s, kids said things, and my grandmother had this habit of saying, you know, it's like been umpteen years since we've seen this person, or it's been umpteen this or that. And Dwayne, like, very innocently said, are you, like, umpteen years old? And they, like, scolded him because he asked this question. And we're like, what's the deal? It's never an honest question. And so we just, he was just a joy to have as a cousin. We were blessed. And he will live on, like, through our memories, I think, you know. But the one word, I was thinking about it. I moved away in 1978 when I was married. I moved to California, moved to Beverly. And so I have not lived here since 77. I never got to meet Lotta. I never got to see Lotta perform, but saw lots of pictures. And I missed that I didn't get to do that. But, I've been thinking about, you know, what it is that we'll remember the most about Dwayne. And what's the thing? And the word I keep hearing in my head is legacy. And everybody that spoke so far was like, he left this legacy of love and beauty and creativity and just joie de vivre. And I love that about him, and that everyone in this room has a moment that they remember about him that will, when they close their eyes, we will remember that, and it'll make us smile. And Greg, I just want you to know, we're always here. You know, you've been married almost as long as I've been married, so we'll always be here with you as your family. We'll always be here to look after you. You're still one of our cousins. Nothing's changed. And so if anybody could just right now, just close your eyes and think of that one thing that you remember about Greg. Raise your glass and say thank you for everything he gave us. Thank you.
Hi there. I am Scotty DeMore Fox, Scott Bishop Walker. Lotta was my empress. Events like this are to celebrate the person, but we don't do this for the person, we do this for us. We have to remember that this is how we come to grips with our loss. And I'm not going to apologize because my tears are justified. When we come to an event like this, we look around and we see the people that celebrate that person with us that we knew, that we know, and we have years, decades of incredible memories. The slideshow that was running earlier was a very cut down version of what I originally put together. Greg had asked me to put the slideshow together and sent me a folder of 3,300 pictures. And then there were another 195 from Coronation. And then I had put together a slideshow for Coronation out of the something like 2,800 pictures I had. And it took a while to get through all of that. And what I ended up whittling that down to was the stuff that I could not possibly get rid of to have pictures of who Dwayne was, who Lotta was. And through all of these years, going through all of that, all I saw was the last 20 years of my life. And then all of the people that I've met, Dwayne's family that's sitting around in the room that I have been lucky enough to meet, and Craig and his family that I have been lucky enough to meet and spend time with, and all of the places around this planet that we have gone. Rhonda, when she was reading that, mentioned a lot of the places. There were so many more. That we had been to, had experiences, and were so lucky to get to go and spend time together. When you run for the title of Emperor and Empress, you don't run together, you run individually, and it's the luck of the draw who you get elected with. And I have to say, I was really, really lucky. We were complimentary. Lotta didn't have a lot of years of experience with the court. I had worked at the Embers a very, very, very long time ago. and I had been around the court back then. And so as we started putting our experiences together and figuring out how we wanted to do all of this and how we wanted to do fundraising, we found that if we played to our strengths with each other, she was the one that was the head in the clouds, and I was the one stuck down here saying, no, come back, come back, come back. it's good to dream, but we have to find a way to actually make something happen. And we did that, and we did it very, very well. Thank you. And when our year came to an end, because we only get to do this for a year, Lotta, Dwayne had become very good friends with our friend Curtis, Allison Gray, and Daddy Frank was a very good friend of mine. And we said, we're not going to create another award. We're not going to create another scholarship fund. We're not going to do that. We just want to come work with you. We want to help expand what you guys do. We have a passion for this. We want to do this. And they let us join the leadership team. And it was their 25th anniversary when we stepped up, or when we stepped down. I can't remember one of those years. And so far, that scholarship fund has raised very close to $750,000 and given that away. I consider myself to lead something of a blessed life. I am lucky enough to have traveled around the world with very, very good friends, and to have held a title in this organization and in this city with so many incredible role models, and to participate in that fundraising and making the world a better place. And to have had Dwayne and Greg as my friends. Thank you.
Thank you to all who spoke. That was, oh boy. Okay, so now. No, I'm good. What am I doing? You don't need this one, right? You do? He said yes and you said no. Okay, I'm just gonna put it here.
Jesus, corn.
Okay. Now, oh, actually, okay, whatever. Please welcome Dwayne's cousin, Julie. Hey, Julie.
So I need you to pause here for a second. I know why the skirts are so short. Those are rockin' legs. Hello, everyone. I wanted to tell a little story, too, from our family. Dwayne was burned on our hearts in a very big event for Janine, my cousin, Greg's sister. When she got married, they chose a little chapel in Walla Walla. And Dwayne and Greg showed up and we did the rehearsal and then we went back to Greg's mom's house. And Dwayne goes, well, there's some flowers that we need to attend to and here's Greg and I, right? And they proceed to take out, I think, nearly 1,000 roses. And I'm like, oh, wow, what are we gonna do with all those? And Dwayne goes, here's what you're doing. Uh-oh, what's that? He goes, you're gonna help us tie all of these. I'm like, there's Greg and I, what? He proceeded to turn us into a flower tying, finely oiled engine. There was so many flowers. Thank goodness he put some of them in bouquets because I was like, oh my gosh, how are we gonna do this? Everyone was wearing the most beautiful roses. And this, what, you know, people tonight said, Dwayne does everything all the way. Absolutely. I was in awe how he could take Greg and I, who basically couldn't do any of this, and do all of this amazing, beautiful things that made Janine's wedding so lovely. So, just Gregory, I want you to know that we love Dwayne and that we're sorry this happened. And we are here for you, just like everyone here, right? So, thank you. I just wanted you to know how amazing Dwayne was for us as well. So I have another story. When someone passes that is so amazing, you are all such an amazing reflection of such a wonderful person. I'm like, you tell such a big story. And we all can look around at each other and go, we're amazing, he's amazing. This is why we're all here. I wanted to do something special. Greg asked me to do music, and I brought some friends with me. Sometimes you have to bring some talent with you to make a little music. And I brought Ken, Sandy, and Pat from the Rose City Flute Choir. Thank you. I'm actually a little nervous because so many of you are such good performers. I'm like, oh boy, here we go. I reached out to a woman who is an amazing composer. Her name is Gabrielle Apri, and she composed the piece of music for cello and piano. And we're going to play it tonight. She sent it, when I told her about our situation, she gave me that music without asking for any money. And she sends her love to you tonight and wishes for you peace and that this builds hope. That this beautiful piece of music, it's called Stargazing. And Ken, my friend, rearranged it for us tonight. So this is truly a very special piece of music and we are going to dedicate it to Dwayne and whenever a flute choir plays it, they'll see his name on it from here on out. Yes, and so I'm a little nervous still, but I will say this, the video that comes with this piece of music, it's on her website. It starts out with her in her farm and with animals dressed in overalls, and she finds a door in her beautiful, in the daytime, in her beautiful field, and she passes through it. As she passes through it, she changes, her clothes change into this most beautiful flowing gown, and she looks to the sky and sees the most beautiful starry night. This piece is a contemplative piece about amazing stars. The stars in the heavens, of course, are nothing but eternal sparkles. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so one of the things that Lotta hated is when I referred to her as a rich white lady. I'm sorry, a flute choir is a rich white lady. I never seen none of that at no black people funeral, child. Never, ever. That was some rich white lady shit. Okay. Okay, so. I was back there going, are you kidding me? Thanks, Clint. Okay, so, you know, Lotta was about so many things as we've heard tonight. A lot of fun, a lot of laughs, a lot of liquor. We are now transitioning into the Lotta Fun. We are having a show bringing you Lotta's favorite performers from, we have, I'm supposed to look at my phone again. Sorry, because if I don't, I'll forget somebody and then Bolivia will cuss me out. So tonight we are bringing to you, oh wait, not yet, sorry. First, sorry, that's why I have to look at my phone. Grab a glass of whatever you have. The name Lotta Liquor was not just a funny name. It was a situation, okay? All of us, Misha and I traveled coast to coast, all the way down to Peru, everywhere, Canada, everywhere with Lotta. And there were times when Lotta was like, you know, I'm not gonna drink. Girl, when Lotta didn't drink, it was no Lotta Fun, okay? She was bad, she was crabby. The lady, the neighbor that said she held on to a grudge, if she didn't drink, she was mad. So we're gonna raise the glass, because that's what Lotta would do, that's what Lotta would want. Again, looking out at the room, I see friends from Darcel 15 and Company, the Rose Court, the Commodore, the Silverado, all the places that Lotta love to go to. This is wonderful. So raise your glass. This is for our friend who we will always love and never forget. To Dwayne Witzel, Lotta Liquor. And we're now gonna have our show, which I know some of you are like, wait, it's a show? Yes, it's a show, girl. We got more beads we need to put on. And can I give this to you? Thank you. Don't drink it. Okay. So, because the show's gonna run and it's gonna be back-to-back entertainment, lots of fun and exciting. First of all, I wanna remind you that the bar is still open. So the bar is open, and enjoy the show. If you would like to contribute to the Pride of the Rose Scholarship Fund, the tip jar's there. All the performers are happy to put their tips in there, or you can just put in there yourself. I don't know that the Pride of the Rose is that advanced that they have Venmo, but we'll work on that, right? Frank and Scott, we'll work on that. But you could do cash, a blank check, whatever, we'll figure it out. So tonight we have the fabulous entertainers, Princess Rhonda Marie, Princess Misha Peru, the fabulous Lavenda De La Rosa from Seattle, Washington, Rose Empress Maria Peters Lake, and fabulous Empress of San Diego, Lala Tu. You are about to have a show curated by Lotta's circle of friends, but we're kicking it off with one of Lotta's favorite entertainers. Please welcome from CC Slaughter's, the amazing Bolivia Carmichaels.
But you got to have friends. The feelings are so strong. You got to have friends to make that day last long. I had some friends, but they're gone. Something came and took them away, and from the dusk till the dawn, here is where I'll stay. Stand
sal.
Talk about love. Talk about love. Well, it's a matter of love.
Direct from Hollywood, it's Waylon Flowers and Madam.
Hello. Now, for those who've just seen us on Hollywood Squares, this is going to be a little El Diferente. Already you may have noticed that Waylon over here is no ventriloquist. But it doesn't matter, you see, because I'm no fucking dummy. Get ready, it's my favorite word. Well, I don't get to say it much on TV. Peter Marshall won't let me. And with a name like Peter Marshall, Peter Marshall sounds like a security guard at a gay bar. Like my fuzzy? It's from Dicker and Dicker. This one looks like it's been dicked to death, don't it? Of what kind of fur this was. I took it to my furrier. I said, honey, what is this? He says, madam, that is a very large, flat, dead thing. Well, I took it to Shirley, my dresser. I said, here, honey, you sniff this and tell me what you think. Well, she did. She says, ye gods, it's terminal Canadian rat. Everything gives you cancer these days, doesn't it? I mean, every time a fucking rat dies in a laboratory, we lose something else good to eat.
Say, Dollface, aren't you a little late getting out here tonight?
Well, yes, I am, and I do beg your pardon, but I was backstage with my fiancé. That's French for the guy I'm fucking now.
I see.
I'm telling you, those Frenchmen are so wishy-washy, you don't know if you're going to get wished or washed. Doesn't bother me. Once I get my wishy, I usually washy anyway. Oh, but he's a corker. You ought to see him. 6'4", blonde, blue-eyed. 19. I don't think that's a bad IQ for a guy 23, do you? Maud, my best friend, the other night told me, she says, madam, you ought to be ashamed of yourself dating that young kid. You should be more careful. It could be fatal. I said, what the hell, Maud? If he dies, he dies. Maud don't have both oars down in the water. No, I bought her a vibrator for her birthday. She knocked out 4 teeth the first afternoon.
She really did. She did, you know.
Well, I guess we all have friends like Maude. I mean that you don't know what to get them for a gift. Like last Christmas, I thought, what am I going to get Maude? Well, finally, I wound up this little love boutique, bought her the cutest little rubber man, the kind you blow up life-size and the pee-pee gets hard. You've seen the kind. Well, Christmas Eve, I got that thing out of the box, started to blow him up. I blew him up real big. Maude's a chubby chaser. I got him El Grando Rotundo there. Rolled it over and corked it. What a cute place for the plug. Well, I took that thing into Maude's room. She was already sacked out in the bed there, waiting for St. Nick. She's got terrible adenoids. Start, take that thing and jam it up her nose. But I didn't. I just laid it next to her in the bed and covered them both up with a blanket. Next morning, I got up. Maude's already in the kitchen there washing out her eyelashes. Boy, she loves that busy work. I leaned and I said, well, Merry Christmas, Maude. She says, Merry Christmas, madam. I said, well, did you get my gift? She says, sure did. I said, well, says, well, what? I said, well, how did you like it? Says, I don't know. I bit him on the neck, he farted and flew out the window. welcome to hell. You just don't take care of your toys, darling.
Oh, come on now, give the old gal a break. She can throw a funeral. She really... When her husband Harry died, that was the best funeral I ever went to.
I guess you're right.
Yeah.
You'd never believe this. Harry was cremated. She had him cremated. I'll never forget the day the ashes arrived at the door, COD. She paid about $4.98 for him, took him into the kitchen, that's where she loves to do work, dumped him out on the counter there, smoothed him out, started diddling with him with a finger, even spelled a name out. Oh, Harry, remember that fur coat you promised me all those years? It's hanging upstairs in the closet. And the Cadillac? It's parked outside in the garage. And the diamond bracelet? It's in the bank in the vault this very minute. All bought and paid for with your insurance. Oh, Harry, remember that blowjob I promised you all those years?
Isn't that a touching story? Tells you a lot, doesn't it?
Oh, my God.
Maude would have loved that, wouldn't she?
Oh, Maude would have loved being here, yes. I'm sorry I had to leave her back in Hollywood. But I travel with her a lot. I took Maude over to Rome to see the Pope. Never forget that day. God, we were coming out of the Vatican there, shooing the pigeons. Ah! Don't do that, I'm church people. Oh, God, I hate birds. I used to hate flies until I learned how to open one. Well, there we were. Maude and I headed up this hill. I looked way up top. There was a lady headed towards us, one of her boobs hanging out. Maude, you see that? The lady on the hill, do you see her? Well, put on your fucking glasses and look. Do you see her now? She's got El Bubalola hanging out, honey. I wonder if she knows. I think I'll go tell her. So I raced over to her, the best Italian that I could muster. I said, quel breste, el expose. Honey, did you know you have a titty hanging out? She says, oh my God, I must have left the kid on the bus.
Telling me the way to move. I feel the spirit.
take a look. Give me the hook or the ovation. It's my one that I want to have a little pride in my oneness. Not a place I have to hide in. Life's not worth a damn till you can say, hey world, I am what I am. I am what I am. I don't want praise, I don't want pity. I bang my own drum. Something gets noise, I think it's pretty. Sparkle and each spangle. Why not try to see things from a different angle? Your life is a sham till you can shout out loud, I am what I am. I am what I am. Excuses. I dare
Did I turn myself off? Oh my gosh. Thank you all. Everyone in this room. The proof of a life well lived. Look around. Each and every one of you. We are family. We're your family, Greg. We're your family. Thank you all so much for coming out. Thank you to the Melody Event Center, Kimberly Van Patten, Clint, all the people that helped put everything together. Scott and Eric, thank you for all the flowers and doing everything. Lavanda, thank you for not shaving. Lotta would like to see that Snow White chest hair. Thank you to everybody that came out and shared your stories. The planned part of tonight has come to an end. They're gonna bring up the lights. The bar is still open. Please share stories amongst yourselves. The way we keep our friends' memories alive is sharing stories. I'd like to point out that Misha and I have not said one thing about our time in Peru with Lotta because there's family here. That's quiet. If you want to hear those stories, we'll be at the Silverado later. Tell your stories, share your stories. When our friends pass away, it's our job to continue their legacy. Lotta wanted fun, she wanted fabulousness. So always be fun and fabulous. Always have a drink. And those of you that don't drink, thank you. More for us. And it's, we will always remember Lotta. We're always going to remember Lotta. Remember New Year's Day when y'all are hungover and full of regret. That's Lotta's birthday. So I ask you, one thing I'm going to ask you is forever on New Year's Day, remember Lotta. You can have a B-52, but they're very expensive and hard to make.
On behalf of Greg and Dwayne's family, I want to thank Ms. Poison Marie Waters, who, even though I gave her my wrong phone number and someday she'll love me again, made this celebration a celebration, along with all of the cast, including Tim, who's sitting down there, his first time up here. Thank you very much. I also want to give a huge thank you to Kimberly Van Patten, who always reaches out. And she's our lesbian Lotta. She really is, kind of. I know, she needs to learn how to be Kimberly. But Kimberly set this all up, reached out to Greg, helped get everything organized for tonight. You are all beautiful people. Poison, I can't thank you enough. Lala for flying from San Diego, and Lavanda, and Misha, and Maria, and Scott, my emperor, and Eric, and all of Dwayne's family who took a chance to come play with us today and celebrate Dwayne. We're a crazy group of people, but boy, we love hard. So, thank you. Have a great night. And like Poison said, the bar's open and there's still a bucket up here if you have a little extra greenery you'd like to add for the Pride of the Roses scholarship. Ones, fives, tens, twenties, hundreds. Yeah, it's green. Gregory said blank checks. He'll fill them out for you. It's all good.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you all so much. Thank you. God bless you all. And remember Lotta. Remember Dwayne for always. Thanks, everybody. Good night. Thank you.
I feel